Meanwhile, the World Wide Web has scooped the media and made the colossal squid a cyber star. Webcams have been sending continuous real-time video from the lab to the internet and sparked an international sensation. Around the world, millions are now riveted by the melting of a frozen squid. It's their final day in the lab, and the scientists are running out of time. With only minutes to go before a horde of media and VIPs arrive, the squid still partly frozen. The show must go on. Thawed or not, the star's ready for its close-up.
We're almost there. It was a colossal headache.
At last, the media session is over, and not a moment too soon. Nothing goes bad faster than raw squid.
We have a deadline within which to examine the squid, and it's really narrow. It's only 4 hours. Because if we take any longer than that, the specimen is just going to be destroyed.
Using a video poll camera, Steve takes his first look. And the first thing he sees sends a ripple of excitement through the lab.
So we're coming into the eye. Wow.
Floating eerily inside its head, one of the squid's massive eyes is intact.
Oh, you've got a beautiful eye in here. Absolutely sensational. It is marvelous.
Hey, look at that.
Dan and Eric have come halfway around the world for this. To be the first vision scientist to look into the eyes of a colossal squid, and to find out if colossals have the largest eyes on Earth.
It's actually, yes, it is the ventral.
Steve lets them remove a gigantic lens from inside the eye.
50 millimeters.
So that the larger is 50 and the smaller is 45 millimeters in diameter.
The two halves fit together to make a single lens that's as big as an orange in the middle of the eyeball.
Weight of the squid, unfortunately. If we wrap a string around the perimeter of the eye, we can actually get the circumference of the eye.
Dan and Eric use a length of string to measure the diameter of the squid's eyeball.
Around the largest ever recorded.
Oh, yeah. So that's the diameter. That's what I got out.
It's an astounding diameter of 10.5 inches, larger than a soccer ball. Proof that the colossal squid really may have the largest eyes on the planet. No one's ever found a male colossal squid. As they probe deeper, the team's hoping for a boy. Everyone's looking for the hectocotylus, a modified arm that male squid use to impregnate females. For one enthralling moment, Steve thinks he's found it.
Hectocotylus, hectocotylus, we've got a male.
It's a male.
It's a male.
It's a male. It's got a hectocotylus.
But,
it's got a, hang on, fourth, yeah, look at that. Yep, it's a male. It's a male.
Is it male?
Yeah.
But okay. here
no,
is
all... that's embarrassing. That is
but
so embarrassing.
Here is also hectocotylus, the other arms. Yeah.
Uh-oh, hang on.
The hectocotylus proves to be just a damaged arm.
We're particularly interested in finding the male of the species because it hasn't really been described adequately. So what we found here was modification of the very arm tip in a manner that's kind of consistent with a hectocotylus. And the hectocotylus is used by the male to transfer packages of sperm to the female. And that's why. It was just a moment of excitement, but it was a little premature. Cat, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
As they free it from the ice, they hit another obstacle.
Easy.
The mantle's torn.
What's this?
Okay, I've got ice.
And that could scuttle plans to put the squid on display.
What? Hang on, I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
Hold on.
It is, yeah. It is damaged, look. We can rebuild it. We'll just get in there with the basic darning needle and stitch it back together again and nobody will be the wiser.
The really big news is that the world's first intact colossal squid is a girl.
See anything.
Oh, yeah.
And you've got eggs, and that's...
Female.
I was really wanting a male, you know.
I'm a little disappointed that it's a female because I really wanted to have a male. I don't know what the male looks like. Nobody knows what the male looks like. It's one of those great unknowns.
1.2.
There's no time to brood. The clock's ticking. Soon the squid will stop thawing and start rotting.
You can magically come across.
It's time to take some accurate measurements. This historic moment brings another disappointment.
2.15.
Okay. As the team measures the squid, one crucial number is unexpectedly small.
4.21 is the total length.
Total length, yes.
Steve was expecting the squid to be more than 30 feet long. It's only half that.
That's a lot shorter than we'd imagined. We had originally an estimate of 10 meters in total length. And it's quite possible that it was, because the tentacles might have been out. I don't know what's going on.
Steve's already had two sleepless nights riding shotgun on the defrosting tank. Now he's confronted with a discovery
total
that may challenge everything he thought he knew about how colossal squids grow.
It's a bit of an anticlimax, I think, isn't it? Because it is actually shorter than we were imagining. As things grow in weight, you do expect them to grow in size. Now, this has got me scratching my head yet again, but there is a possibility that instead of growing long, the specimen grows round, so it increases in bulk rather than length. But that's science we learn every day.
Short as she may be, this squid is still the heaviest invertebrate ever found. But the team's research isn't just skin deep.
That's the head. That way.
They're about to take the world's first journey inside a completely intact colossal squid and see things never seen before.